Hey, and Fash, 2nd of February, 2019. This is something that is blowing my mind, and I'll tell you, things are being poured out like I've never seen, and the best I can do is just, like, give this out and pray that, you know, someone sees through the glass a little bit different than I do, and we can glean out of this what we're trying to be shown. But the fact of the matter is this stuff cannot be dismissed. I mean, my spirit bears witness to this stuff. I just can't tell you exactitudes of what it means, you know what I mean? But it's just absolutely crazy. And it began with this article this morning because what this ended up doing was bringing back something from a couple years ago that I'm going to do the best I can to share with you because, again, like I said, it's just really crazy. This Hawaiian Airlines flight was headed to Maui, and it had to return to LAX three times over unrelated issues. Three times. That's pretty crazy. So I just start reading it, and more than 200 Hawaiian Airlines passengers aboard flight 33, okay? So this flight 33 had to turn around three times, leaving Los Angeles, which is on the 33rd parallel, which is where the Rams are from, okay? The rest of this article is actually kind of lame. They kind of talk away the whole situation, but I did notice there are 207 passengers, okay? Now, the threes, and just this is the way my brain works. I take the 207, okay, and I calculate it by three. I divide it by three, and interestingly enough, it's exactly divisible by 69. Three times, 207. Flight 33 turned around three times on the 33rd parallel, and you could, I guess, technically say on the 33rd day of the year, because I didn't click the little box when I looked at this yesterday. You see the little box here, I didn't click it, so actually today is the 33rd day if you include the day. If I take the little box out and go to the 3rd, it'll still say 33, so that's what happened there. But so, yeah, you could say today's the 33rd day of the year, is what I'm getting at, essentially, for flight 33, okay? And what gets really weird is how this ties back in to something I was shown couple years ago, which I can't find the videos in my channel because I didn't keep track of the names, the titles, but they're in there. 2017, almost all of them. But what it was on Drudge Report. It was on April the 6th of 2017 that it hit me so much that I was led to take a screenshot of the Drudge Report, and this is what it was on April 6, 2017. Republicans push button, and they have this image of this nuke, and this was on there all day long. And if you look at the screenshot here, I'll try and get it up. There it goes. Okay, see down here the date I took the screenshot, 4/6/2017 at 1:08. And I was just led to do that. I at the time, I didn't realize what I was going to see in this because I went and I got the original high definition or whatever you call it, high resolution image of that nuclear blast, right? And this is it right here, the same as the one that was on Drudge Report. Same exact image, just a higher resolution, you know what I mean? And so I started looking at it, and I'll tell you what, you guys, this is no normal image here. This is demonic to the core. We'll start right here. Look at this cloud. I mean, right in your face on Drudge Report all day. They got demons, you know, the cloud shaped like demons flying at you, like attacking, okay? And inside this cloud is so much absolute evil. I can't even... And I'm sure some of you, if you really have the eyes, it's just the way I see this stuff. I could point out probably a dozen faces of death and misery and horror. But the main thing I want to point out is down here. If you look on the surface here. This is obviously like in the ocean, presumably out west, maybe, I would think. That's what I was, you know, came to the conclusion. We have these oil rigs out here, okay? Not too many places with oil rigs right offshore like that. And then over here, I want you to notice this crazy looking cloud that's shaped like a wishbone, okay? This is important because of what was shown to me just a few days after this happened on April the 6th, okay? All right, I gotta insert this little piece here. This is 3 days after this came out on the Drudge. 3 days after this was on Drudge on April 6th, I saw this in the sky, okay? No word of a lie. This is April 10th. I believe I saw it April 9th and put it up on the 10th. It, whatever. But this was in the sky outside my house, okay? Think about this stuff, you guys. That is insane. Beyond insane. I had the camera the wrong way, and then I turned it level there. Look at that thing. I mean, come on. Look at that cloud right there. And then tell me that you wouldn't freak out after 3 days after seeing this demonic craziness off the shore of California with the crazy cloud like that in it. And then you see that in your backyard 3 days later, which, you know what I mean? So I really hope this is clicking with somebody. What that led to was me going onto a map, literally onto Google Earth, but I can't run it on this computer now. And where that image led me was to California, right in LA here. Okay, and there right here, if you went on Google Earth, you would see the oil rigs right here. You'd see three of them that I know of for a fact on Google Earth. There's probably more. But out here is Catalina Island, and there is literally a place on this island is an intersection of roads up in the mountains here that are literally referred to as wishbone. I kid you not, that you can actually look that up. That's how crazy that is. And you'll find it. Wishbone. So bottom line is I'm seeing the oil rigs out here, Catalina Island out there. That's what I'm led to understand. That's where that nuke takes place, which would put it like right in here somewhere. Right off of Huntington Beach, right here. That's just where it is shown to me to be. And, you know, it never ends, you know. I mean, the confirmations just come in over and over and over. Because, you know, I showed you it's the 33rd day, right? But if you go all the way back to the day that article came out, April the 6th, 2017, and you go to the day that this happened, okay? Really, if you think about it, this article is dated the 2nd, but it's 12:37, okay? So it's literally 12:30 in the morning in this time zone. You see what I'm saying? This came out early this morning, so, you know, it happened on the 1st. So I don't like messing with the dates. I hate the dates, but these are so close. It's like, you can't dismiss this stuff. You know what I'm saying? In that time frame, get a load of this, 666 days. Now, you can't just talk that away. Flight 33, okay, on the 33rd day, with 207 passengers divided by 3 is 69, exactly, has to turn around three times. And I'm brought to mind, to LA, is brought back to my memory, this image that just, I was led, I mean, I can't even explain to you why would I have held on to this image and discovered all these things in it, like the king, okay? If that doesn't sum it up, I don't know what will. There is a king in this explosion. Do you see him right there? That's his face right there. He's got a crown and everything. It's like looking off into the distance, you know, all noble looking and everything. They had a king over them. And it even transfers into another creature if you really study this image. there's a profile of another creature with very, you know, unpleasant looking features and characteristics, you know, like razor blade teeth and things. And it's all throughout this. So, you know, when this stuff happens, as crazy as it seems, it's real. And I have to share it with you. And hopefully people can, you know, put something together and at the very least recognize that there is a spiritual war going on. And if nothing else, this is just part of this ongoing ritual that's just been carrying on in the dark forever. And now it's all being revealed. And it's all because God's allowing it to be revealed. He wants you to seek Him through His Son, Jesus Christ. That's the key. That's the door. That's the truth. Okay? So, you can't make this stuff up, you guys. And it even goes on, you know, L.A., the Rams, caused me, this is how my mind thinks, to think of the Rams' horns, Joshua 6. Let's go there, because this is interesting, you guys. You got to think about this when I show this to you. Joshua 6. 6:4 to be exact, when he mentions the seven priests, the seven trumpets of ram's horns on the seventh day. You'll compass the city seven times. And what'll happen? The wall falls down. Joshua 6:4, 46, as in 2346. Just like the Super Bowl is on the 3rd, 2346. And if we calculate that, check this out. Now we'll include the day in this one. This is nuts, you guys. It truly is. 669. Just like the 200 passengers divided by 3 is 69. 207 by 3, 69. Again, I just put it out there. And I hope you understand that you are in a literal war for your eternal soul. And Jesus is the only Savior. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord, and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,